You're nearly out of time.
But this bit won't go anywhere.
Keep calm. It will.
It won't.
Time's up. Stop now.
Can I have some more time from when I drop him on the floor, please?
Afraid not, Daphne. Let's see how many pieces you joined up. 1, 2, 3.
Well, that's not fair. I dropped him.
3 out of 7.
We'll have to see if we can do better than that.
It's not fair. Can I have another go, please?
No, we've got to take the first result.
But I want to do it better this time.
No, behave yourself.
Please. Oh, look, I just want to go. Please let me go. Can I go now, please? Please.
Daphne, don't.
I could have done it better.
Hello, what's your hurry?
Oh, I was supposed to be in Anne's office 3 minutes ago, but I'm dying for a cup of coffee before we go over all that paperwork.
Oh, I think you're safe. She's got someone with her.
Oh, good.
By the way, how's Eve Wilder?
Not as calm as she was last night. I don't know what a solicitor said to her, but when they finished, she looked as if she knew she was in real trouble.
Well, it is a murder charge, Meg.
Yes, and I think she's only just realised it may not be quite so easy to prove she's innocent.
Well, mistress or not, she must be feeling terrible if it really was an accident.
Accident? The woman's obviously inventing the whole story. The police know what they're doing.
Yes, they obviously think they've got enough evidence to convict her.
Just because she's beautiful doesn't mean she can't be a liar.
Well, I'm not making any judgments.
I'm right.
Good job you're not on her jury, then.
Guilty.
Guilty?
Guilty.
Guilty. And guilty.
Yes, so what?
You cheated on every woman who bought a number from you. Now you're going to have to pay for it.
Cheated? What about you? You're a bloody fake. You would have been off like a shot if that escape plan had worked. And you, and you.
What escape plan?
You're off your scone. Escape plan?
Oh, you'd be the last to know. Wake up to yourselves. If anyone's doing the deceiving around here, it's them three.
What you going on about, Nora?
She doesn't give a stuff about you. None of you.
She thinks about us all the time.
Oh, not if she could get herself out of here.
Does she know something we don't?
She thinks she does, and as usual, she's wrong.
Like hell. It's just that Lex and me were a jump ahead of you. Right, Lex?
Yeah, we was too smart for you.
So smart, you got the whole thing wrong.
Oh, that's what you think. Nikki was going to go along with your little plan. Only guess who she was going to spring?
Yeah, Lou and me.
How could an old con like you fall for that escape story?
What do you mean? You're not going to try and deny it, are you?
That was for Nikki, wasn't it? And you went and swallowed it all.
I don't understand none of this.
It was to scare Nikki straight. We dreamt up this escape plan and laid it on her that she'd have to kill somebody for us.
It turned her right off.
Yes, she soon discovered the real thing's not so glamorous.
I don't believe you.
Well, you might have told us.
Don't you trust us?
I'll explain later. You weren't so clever after all, were you, Kelly? Now get out of here. Mm. We'll work out your punishment later.
Why? What's the point of keeping it a secret?
I said get out.
Hey, Nora, aren't you going to talk to
him? I can't talk to people like Kelly. It's a waste of time. Cleaning duties aren't going to hassle her either.
No, that sort of punishment's just a laugh as far as she's concerned. And Lexi's getting just as bad. Mm.
Well, don't worry. I've got other ways of dealing with the likes of Kelly.
Lunch, Wilder.
Thanks, I'm not really very hungry. Hello.
Hi. I'm Jacko.
Hey, no talking. Prisoners in solitary are not permitted to talk to other prisoners. You should know better.
Yes, Miss Ferguson. Well, all this is new to me. I'm sorry if I got you into trouble. How long do I have to stay in solitary?
Wait at the gate. I thought you'd have been quite happy to stay in here and grieve by yourself. Sudden change of heart.
Well, staying here isn't going to change what happened. It won't bring Robin back.
See, still claiming it was an accident, hmm?
Miss Ferguson, who do I... My lawyers had to give up the case because of his health. Well, I insisted, and I have to get someone new. Could you help me?
It's not my job.
I'm sorry. I don't know who organises these things. I have to get somebody good. I owe that much to Robin.
I'll see what the governor has to say.
Thank you. I'm sorry to be such a nuisance.
Done it better, honest.
You won't be able to do anything well if you don't calm down.
Look,
now, come on.
Just ask them if they'd let me do it again, please.
Leave me, Daphne. It won't do any good.
It would. I didn't know what I was doing before. They didn't explain it properly.
Okay, so you'll knock them dead on the rest of the tests.
Couldn't you just ask, please?
Wouldn't it make more sense to do the tests again, now she's calmer?
I'm sorry. The results have got to be based on first attempts. I'm sure you can understand that, Mr. Fulbright.
I'll take the blood sample now, Doctor. Blood? We're doing a scan of your hormone levels.
No, I'm not
having a needle. It won't hurt you.
It won't take a second.
No, it'll be something to knock me out, won't it? Put me to sleep,
please,
won't
it? I won't let that happen.
Yeah, then when I'm out to it, they're going to lock me up in here forever and ever, aren't they?
Trust me.
Well, what can you do? You can't do anything about it. They hate me and they want to keep me in here. Just go away.
Listen to me, Daphne. You've got to do the test. This is your chance to show them. You behave like this, you'll blow the whole thing. Now do what the nurse wants. Please.
I'll start cutting up the veggies for dinner as soon as you finish washing that lot up.
Just thought I'd pop in, see how you were.
I think I'll be all right.
And to say it was a lovely lunch. Some of the women said so too.
They were lucky to get anything.
Why, what do you mean?
It never seems to end, does it?
What is it? What's happened?
Luke Kelly was in here before. She knows about Lexi and the blackmail. Brought it up in a nasty way.
Oh, dear. She doesn't know the details, does she?
No, but she might try to dig them up. It's like living under a cloud. Every time I think everything's clear, it comes back again.
It'll be all right. I'll make sure Kelly doesn't do anything stupid somehow.
No, like I've told you, I don't want you getting involved.
Well, do you think we should speak to Nora again?
No, let's not panic.
Let's not panic. But what are we going to do?
Well, like I said, she doesn't know anything. I'm just going to have to be very careful with her. As long as she never finds out about the epilepsy, it'll be all right. I just got too strong about it. It's a fact that I suffer from it. But I'm not going to give in to the likes of her.
Good for you.
When do you think we'll get to see her?
Well, they'll keep her up in solitary for at least 24 hours, love. Maybe not till tomorrow.
Poor girl. If it was an accident, she must feel just terrible.
That's what the papers keep saying, a terrible accident.
I wouldn't take it too seriously. Could mean anything.
Has anyone seen Jacko since she took in her lunch?
Yeah, she reckons she's a real stunner.
Well, she would be, wouldn't she?
Why?
Well, to keep that old guy hooked for so long. He must have finally got sick of her, though.
And what's that supposed to mean?
Well, it's simple, isn't it? A meal ticket looks like taking a walk, so she blasts him.
Why do you have to think the worst of everyone who comes in here?
Because they're usually guilty as hell, that's why.
Then you're just as bad as the people in the system. You won't give anyone a chance.
Oh, I wouldn't say that, love.
Look, I'm innocent. Most of you know that now, but you wouldn't give me a chance to prove it, would you?
That was different.
How? Look, I'm not going to judge this woman until I meet her.
Jenny's right. We should wait and see how it pans out.
Geez, there's a hell of a lot of waiting and talking going on. When on earth are we going to find out what our punishment is?
When we're ready.
Probably can't think of anything bad enough.
Oh, I wouldn't count on that if I were you, Kelly.
I've known Adrian for years, but when he told me what the doctor said, I couldn't let him take on a heavy case like this.
No, I suppose not.
Now, I don't know what to do.
Couldn't he find someone for you?
Well, I did hint that there was someone else wanting to take the case. Well, if he felt that he was leaving me in the lurch, he'd insist on going on with it. And I don't want to have to rely on a complete stranger. Please, could you help me find someone?
Oh, as governor, I can't act for you like that. There are standard procedures, and I don't want the other prisoners to feel that you're being treated favourably.
Of course. I'm sorry, I just wasn't thinking.
I could get legal aid for you. That's something I do quite often.
No, I...